Hey everyone, welcome back to the Generative AI Learning Series by StarAgile. In this series, we'll continue to explore Generative AI and how it's changing the way we work and create. If you're curious about AI or eager to learn more, you are in the right place. I'm Huzaifa, and I'll be your guide throughout this journey. In this fifth chapter, we are going to be exploring LangChain Agents. If you have missed out on any of our previous videos, don't worry, here is the link for you to check them out. So let's get started. Hi everyone. In this session, we are going to start discussing about the agents and tools using LangChain. This will allow us to create smart LLM applications which can automatically decide which tool to call in order to generate an accurate human response. Let's get started. So let's begin by talking about what is an agent. An agent, as I mentioned, is a smart LLM application. So what an agent can do? An agent can look at an input prompt from a user. And this prompt will be evaluated by the agent, right? So here you can see the user will give a prompt and the prompt will go to an agent. Consider an agent to be like a middleman. So depending upon what the prompt says, an agent will evaluate it and see what the user wants to do. Is the user asking for a certain research to be performed, or are they asking us to create an image, or are they asking us to evaluate or let's say calculate a complex expression or a mathematical expression? So depending upon what the prompt is asking, the agent is going to call the respective tool. There are different tools which will be defined, and each tool will perform a single activity. So there could be one tool that is doing image creation, a second tool that is doing research, a third tool that is performing calculations. So depending upon what the prompt says, the agent will evaluate it and redirect the response to the correct tool to get the right answers. Right? So the workflow for an agent looks something like this. It begins by giving a prompt to the user. The user prompt is evaluated by the agent, and then the agent will call the corresponding tool. Right? So there could be one tool called calculator that is calculating our responses, a tool that is researching a Wikipedia page to get the final output back. Depending upon which tool is called, we'll get a result and the response will be formatted by the agent for us. So for this demonstration, we are going to create two tools. The first tool is a calculator tool that will be used for performing or evaluating mathematical expressions. And the second tool that will allow us to perform research using Wikipedia articles. And based upon the user response, the agent will decide which tool to automatically call and give us the accurate answer back. So let's get into the Python and see how to implement such a agentic framework using LangChain. So here I am inside my Jupyter notebook, and as always, we are going to begin by importing our dependencies. We'll load our environment variables using the load.env function. The chat OpenAI will allow us to create a large language model that will be used for evaluating our user expressions. LangChain.agents give us access to the classes for creating an agent executor and another function that will allow us to bind all the functionalities together. So here the create OpenAI function agent, this particular function will allow us to use the LLM as an agent, right? So as you can see here, it will ask us which agent to use, and depending upon, since we are using an OpenAI agent, so here we need to use the OpenAI function agent to call the respective functions within OpenAI. And finally, we'll import tools to define our individual tools. And lastly, Wikipedia import is required. You can install the Wikipedia package. It's open source, and this will allow you to access the data available on Wikipedia's databases. So all of these packages are required. If Wikipedia is not there in your machines, you can simply run the command pip install Wikipedia to easily install these packages. So let's first begin by loading our environment variables. So as always, we'll start by loading the .env file. So once our environment variables are loaded, we are now ready to create our tools first. The first tool that we'll define is a calculator tool. This calculator tool will take an expression as an input. This expression will be of a string format, and it's going to evaluate the results and return us the string back. Now, how this particular tool is going to work? This tool is going to evaluate, right? So for evaluation, we'll use the eval function in Python. This eval function is going to evaluate our expression, and the result of this expression will be stored in a result variable right here. And since all the expressions might not be right, so what we will do, we'll wrap this inside a try catch block. So here what we have done, we have defined a calculator function that takes an expression as an input. It will evaluate this expression and calculate a result. If it is able to evaluate this expression correctly, well and good, otherwise will return an error saying that this particular message could not be evaluated. Right? So whatever the error will be, that will also be part of the value. Now in order to convert this into a tool, you have to decorate it with the tool decorator which we have imported above. This decorator has to be created in order to convert this function into a tool that we'll use for our agent's evaluation. Now, one thing which is missing in this particular case is a doc string. Now, doc strings are very important for you to define in this particular case. With the help of doc strings, the large language model will understand what is the use or the purpose for this tool that you have created. Always remember, it is mandatory to define a doc string whenever you are creating a tool function. Without the doc strings, these tools cannot be evaluated. So they give LLM ability to understand what exactly this function is getting used for. So at the top, we give a doc string which says tool for evaluating mathematical expressions. Then we are trying to evaluate our expression and returning the result back. And if any exception occurs, we are returning the string containing the exception itself. Similarly, let's define another tool. Let's call this tool as WikiSummary. And this particular tool will take input a string, right? So here we'll give a topic for Wikipedia to summarize. So in this particular case, a topic will be given as an input and it will try to research on Wikipedia articles and return us back a summary of those topics. As always, I'm going to provide a doc string first that explains what this tool is getting used for. Here we are saying this tool is meant for getting the details of the topic from Wikipedia. And then finally, we write a try catch block. And here we are using the Wikipedia package, calling the summary function and asking it to summarize this topic in two sentences. So here you can see we are getting the summary within two sentences. And whatever summary we will get, we will return that summary back to the calling function. Now you can see here I have again wrapped it within the same decorator called tool. So here we have created two simple tools, one to calculate expressions and second to summarize articles meant from Wikipedia. Let's now combine these tools in a single list. So what we will do is we'll create an object called tools, which is basically a list of tools that we want to use. And next up, we are going to define a large language model here. This large language model is going to be used for evaluating our expressions. Okay. So here the API key has to be loaded. So I'll just load it from my environment variables list. So here we have created a list of tools to use, and secondly, we have created a large language model that will allow us to evaluate the user inputs. Next up, we have to define a prompt, right? So now it's time to create our prompt. Now here we are going to use again the chat prompt template dot from messages feature. So this particular function within chat prompt template allows you to create a simple template. Now here we have to remember three things. The first one is a system level prompt. The system level prompt will basically tell large language model what it needs to do. Here we are saying you are a helpful AI assistant that can use tools to answer the user's questions. So here this chat prompt template we need to import as well. So let's quickly import it here. Right, so we are going to import our chat prompt template and our messages placeholder as well. After we have imported these two, you will see that we are able to use them below. So system level prompt is basically that you are an AI assistant, which is going to use tools to answer the user's questions, followed by the input that the user has provided. The user is going to give certain input. And lastly, this is something which is very unique for agents. So here we will see whenever you define prompts for agents, you need to provide a placeholder for agent scratchpad. So what this agent scratchpad is, it's basically a placeholder that allows agent to think and improve itself. So obviously the agent is going to do a lot of reasoning before deciding which tool to use. And the scratch pad is basically the place where agent will put all of its thinking and try to see which is the exact tool to use. Okay. Consider it to be a default placeholder that you have to keep whenever you need to define a prompt template for an agent calling. So now our prompt template is also ready. Next up, we are ready for defining our agents. So let's define an agent here. using the function create open AI functions agent. So this particular function will take the LLM as an input. So remember, this is the large language model that we have defined. It will also take the tools that this large language model has to process and the prompt that it needs to use in order to give the right answer. So all of these three have to be tied up together, and therefore we are using the create OpenAI functions agent to create an agent right here using the OpenAI functions agent call. And we'll basically create an agent executor as well. This agent executor will take our agent tools and essentially execute our agent in order to get the right response. So think of it as a chain that we are defining, which will help us to define a graph and invoke the agent depending upon which tool it has to use. Right? So this is our agent that we have created, and this is basically the executor that will execute the agent depending upon the user input. So let's first recap what we have done until now. So we started off by defining our two tools. Remember, one tool to calculate, one tool for summarizing. Right? Agent will decide which tool to use depending upon the input response. Right? So if you are asking it to evaluate some mathematical expression, it will call the first tool. If you are asking it to summarize a Wikipedia article or any topic in general, it will use the second tool. We are combining those two tools together into a single list of tools that we want to create. And here we are defining a large language model, which will be the agent model that is going to be called. The prompt template allows us to define how the agent has to function. The system level prompt here is saying that it's a helpful AI assistant that can use tools to answer the user's question. We are then defining the input that the human has provided and a placeholder for agent to think within itself. Then an OpenAI function will define an agent for us using the large language model defined above, and the executor will help us execute this agent using the input query that the user has given. Now all that's left to do is define a chat interface that can help us to interact with our agent using the inputs. So let's do that now. Let's define a simple loop. And the first thing that we will do is we'll ask the user an input. Right? So this user input will be written here. And once the user has given an input, we are going to use the agent executor and invoke our agent by passing the user input here. Right? So remember, this user input will go to our agent and the agent will be invoked over here. And before that, we'll first check if the user input is exit. If exiting, then we'll break out of the loop. If the user input is not to exit, we'll basically call the agent executor right here. So once the agent executor is done running, it will return us a response back, and this response will be printed right in this fashion. Right? So we'll call the output to get the output that has been returned to us by the agent call. So let's run this and see this particular tool in action. Let's write a simple expression. Tell me the result for 4 times 5 plus 10. So you can see here it is logging us as well. It's saying that it has invoked the calculator with expression 4 into 5 plus 10. And here it was also showing you the result as well. So the result of this expression is 30, right? So 4 times 5 is 20 plus 10 is 30. That's correct. And here you can see once it has finished, it is also telling you the output as well. So the result of the expression is 30. So whatever expression you had passed, it has evaluated that expression and the answer for this question has been given to us as 30. Let's ask another question. Let's say, who is Nikola Tesla? So now this time, depending on our question, it has seen that we want to get the summary. So therefore, it has automatically called the Wiki summary tool, provided the topic as Nikola Tesla, and basically Wikipedia has responded back with this text, and here you can see it has summarized the answer back to us. So Nikola Tesla, this is what the lifespan of that person was. He's a Serbian American engineer, futurist and inventor, and other things about Nikola Tesla as well. So over here what we have done is we have given two different expressions to evaluate, and based on the user input, the tool itself was invoked based on the agent's evaluation of the expression. And finally, we got the result back in this fashion, right? So these results are returned back to us via the agent call itself. Let's also pass another prompt, but this time the input will contain both. Tell me about Nikola Tesla and answer the expression 2 + 40. Multiplied by 3, whatever, right? So here we are asking it to do two things simultaneously. So in this single expression, we are asking the model to first tell us who Nikola Tesla is, and also we are asking it to evaluate an expression. Let's see if the model can accurately identify that it needs to make two different calls. So here, as you can see, here first of all, it called the first API, which basically, you can see that all the logs are printed here. So first of all, it essentially called a wiki summary to get the summary for the Wikipedia article from Nikola Tesla. And second, it automatically identified it needs to make one more call to evaluate the expression as well. So here, whatever expression we had passed, it evaluated that expression and answer was 122 as well. So as you can see, even though we had given a single response, we had given a single user query, but that user query contained two instructions. And both those instructions were identified by a large language model. And to evaluate those individual instructions, LLM made a corresponding tool call to give us the right output. So all these questions that we had asked were successfully returned to us back by the agent. So it was able to evaluate an expression, tell us who Nikola Tesla was, and also return us a response when the prompts were actually combined, right? So we had two expressions wherein we wanted to know two things simultaneously in a single expression. So basically, in this session, we have successfully built an agent using LangChain. In the last session for this, so in this session, we have successfully built an agent using LangChain. In the next session, we are going to combine all the previous concepts and essentially create a capstone project that will allow us to create an agent using RAG as well. So I'll see you in the next lecture. Thank you very much. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and give it a thumbs up. We've got more exciting Gen AI episodes coming your way very soon. Also, if you are looking to earn a globally recognized certification in automation testing and Gen AI, be sure to check out the StarAgile certification courses. Thanks for watching and keep learning. I'll see you in the next video.